I had a vivid picture, contemplatively in a daydream, of a woman standing in a Gothic arch. There is both tension and peace in that threshold, and a sense of being held, being safe. Surprised by the sudden death of my husband, I have been further surprised by the depth of life and beauty found being immersed in deep grief and sorrow. Echoing the mystery of our human experience, art can open us in new ways, transforming us as we learn to become vessels of greater capacity. Perhaps even turn our hearts to a new facet of life and beauty from the ashes of our lives and sorrow, like a portal where the spirit touches the soul and love can have the next word.
Tis a rare and knowing patron who can slow themselves to the pulse and cadence required to walk the meandering corridors of the artist. And when the artist in turn is invited to walk a few miles alongside a spiritual sojourner, a capacious soul, bright with wisdom and faith, he has really only one tenable answer. How far? Over many months, in open-handed and long-pondering exchanges marked by her luminous intelligence, curiosity, and attention, Lisa has partnered into the conception of this artwork with grace and trust enough to light a path to this image.
It is a gift to have a sacred space like the Garden of Remembrance to pour our loved ones' ashes. There are over 500 souls' ashes interred there. When visiting the garden, one is often vulnerable, reflective. Having a public piece of art in the garden to abide with, should a visitor choose, is the intention that seeded the idea that became Limina.
A stone's throw from the fast arterial flow of the street, this silent vision would stand in the way of all art. That is, dreaming out loud for the benefit of them that pass. This lone figure, this empathic embodiment in bronze and steel, astride the elements, the seasons, generations, is heedless of time. With only gesture and poise, her story is told in a single frame. The turning of a single page, that at the liminal moment a grace may rise, that the veil may yield to the yearning hand, that light may come to the vigilant eye.
David has gestated the seed of intention for this and created something beautiful from the ashes of sorrow, as seen here in Limina.
I myself have come to think of the vision of this work as like an anchor hold of memory within the church garden. That there would stand this waiting and vulnerable figure, keeping vigil in dark northern hours, and ever attuned to a glimpse of the southern sky in which abides the sun, humanity's most ancient dream motif of the divine.
It is our prayer that the sculpture be an offering to the Trinity that the Spirit of God can use to minister to the spirit within of the visitor, and they too sense being held, being safe.